Hey guys, I'm Theo Joe, and if you're like me, you've probably wondered if it was at all possible to play a console game disc on your PC. It sure would be nice, and for a while I thought it was impossible, but recently I figured out there's a way you can actually do it, and it's really easy, and that's exactly what I'm going to show you how to do in this video. I'm going to show you how to play a Xbox One game on the PC. Now obviously Microsoft does not want you to know how to do this, and they don't even want you to know it's possible, but it is possible with a little bit of know-how. You see, game discs are just computer programs, but they are protected from DRM, licensing software, that sort of thing, to make sure that they are only playable on their respective consoles. It would be really bad for business if you could play a game disc on any console, because then you wouldn't have to buy the respective one and make more money for the company. But there is a way for your computer to actually bypass that protection on Windows, so you can play it like a normal game and it completely ignores any of that protection and runs it just like a console would. And it's important to note that we're not going to be damaging the disc, it's still going to be usable on your console, we're just disabling the protection on the computer side, so we're not changing anything on the disc at all. So let's go to the computer and I'll show you exactly how to change this setting. It's surprisingly easy, only takes a couple of seconds really, and I'll demonstrate how you can boot into an Xbox One game right from your PC. Okay, so I'm at the computer right now, and you just want to go to wherever it shows you all the discs and that sort of thing. It's called This PC in Windows 10. It's called My Computer in previous versions. Doesn't really matter. I have the Xbox One game disc inserted already, and it's Assassin's Creed Black Flag, and this is what you would see. It doesn't really show anything, because obviously it's not meant to run on PC. If you double-click it to try to run it, nothing happens. You can't really see any files in here, just a couple of images and that sort of thing. This is what you would see before you change the setting. Now, what you need to do is actually right-click once the game disc is installed on the disc drive it's in. You go to Properties after right-clicking, then you go to Hardware, then you go down and find the disc drive again and go to Properties, then you go to Details, and this is where we're going to find the setting to change. Now you want to go to Capabilities, and then this is the default setting that's selected already. It's just a bunch of gibberish, it doesn't do anything. What we want to select is CM DevCap Raw Device OK. Now this basically is going to allow the disk to read the raw data no matter what type of disk it is. It's going to bypass any protection, it doesn't even look at the type of disk, so just reading the raw data, doesn't care that it's supposed to be for Xbox One. So make sure that's selected and then click OK and then OK again. Now if we go to double click it to run it, the game boots up. All right, so let's make sure that it's working. Okay. Okay, so just in the menu waiting for it to boot up. Maybe get a game started. It's actually letting me use the keyboard, which is surprising. Some might let you use a keyboard. Most probably will require the gamepad. All right, and we can actually boot into the game. It's starting to load. Yep. All right, so it seems to be working okay. And yep, all right, so we're actually in the game. It's going all right, and it's working fine. So that's all there is to it. Alright, so as you saw, it plays fine, and you can now boot your Xbox One games on your PC and play it like normal. Now, it's important to know that this is a console version of the game, so you're not going to be able to have access to as many settings like frame rate, resolution, maybe even graphic settings, because those are usually fixed on the console. This is basically like playing a pure console port on the PC, and you may have to actually use a gamepad that's plugged in through either Bluetooth or USB, or else the game might not allow you to control it with a mouse and keyboard. Sometimes games actually do have a PC version that allows for keyboard built in from a port, but that isn't always the case. So you might have to take note of that and just have a gamepad ready. But other than that, I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to let us know how it goes in the comments section below and give that video a like so I know you guys enjoyed it. If you want to continue watching, I've got some other videos on the right-hand side. You can just click those or look in the description for the same link, like if you're on a phone. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos Monday, Wednesday, Friday, so I think it should be worth it. I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys either in the comments section or on Twitter. So thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Have a good one.